Okay friends, so today we will be giving a view on Nifty as well as Bank Nifty and few of the stocks which I like for the next week. Yep. So for as we discussed last week, the market are going to go down. So two candles were very much down. Okay. Then it almost gave a correction of nearly 4% into the markets, and then we had a relief rally. Relief rally was also discussed. It gave a point upward movement of 182 points. After that, now we are expecting another leg of relief rally, which can have a resistance at these levels, though it is 14,770 levels, and the support for Nifty for next week is going to be in this. So it is going to be the low of last week. That will be 14,260 levels approx. So if it holds these levels, then we are going up. If it does not hold, then we are heading down. That also it is going to find support. And these quotes are way below the expectations. Yeah, so hope this supports held. Last week's support is held up and we move ahead. Yep. Now talking on the Bank Nifty. Now Bank Nifty also, as discussed, we were expecting a correction. Then we had a relief rally. Relief rally was about for 1%, 300 points about. And now for the next week, we are expecting the resistance at around 34,700. And on the downside, we have a support. Last week's support is around 32,415. So if we hold that, we are good. And we are going to move much ahead, but the resistance I'm talking about, so try to clear your positions when the resistance comes at around 34,600 levels. It's a sell on rise market now because it is on a downtick. Yeah, so wait for the trend to emerge and give us the confidence. And there are some so this was my view on Nifty and Bank Nifty, and there are some stocks which I like the Tata Steel. We talk about Tata Steel, it is giving a big up move when the markets are collapsing. That's a very good sign. So you can hold this stock with a support of around 727 for targets of around 800 as a bare minimum. Yeah. If the market starts rising, that's going to go way higher. But it is showing strength in downward markets as well. So we are expecting a very good move by next week. Yeah. The other stock which I want to talk about is Hindustan Unilever. It has got a very good downturn, and after the downturn it has started moving up. Now this is again, it gave a move down. Now after when the market was collapsing, it was going up. So I believe next week also this should have this similar trend. It is going to go up, and once it crosses these levels of around 22,366, then it is going to boom. So let's see and hope for the best for next week. Yep. This was on HUL. Now on Asian Paints, this is the stock which I like a lot. It has had its own correction, it consolidated for a few days, now it has again started moving up. So let's see how it is going to pan out for next week, but I'm quite optimistic on this stock. It is going to go way higher. The targets for me, I believe first targets will be around 2560 to 60 rupees up move is definitely going to come from here. And the Delta Corp, I believe next week is going to be fine because it had a very good jump in the share prices last week when the markets was going down. It is into a business of tourism. Yeah, so let's see how it pans out for the next week, but we are quite optimistic on the share considering a loss, a stop loss of 150 on a closing basis. You can hold this script for next week. Okay friends, so this was the view of Nifty and Bank Nifty and two shares which I like. Hope you like this video and hope I'm helping you guys to identify a few good stocks and some views on Nifty technically as well as fundamentally. So this was my view on the Nifty and Bank Nifty. And the other thing is, like, there is the recent IPOs have not gone well with the markets, and most of the listings were tapered. But now we are expecting, like, after the listing, the company named Ease My Trip IPO has done phenomenally well. I mean, yesterday it was in the upper circuit of 20%. Okay, so that stock should do well from the IPO front, and we are expecting very tapered listings for Barbecue Nation as well, because there are some disclosed in the red herring prospectus, which don't which are not so comfortable for the investors if they go into thoroughly, like they had given some stake to the equity. I mean, those who invested in their equities 3 months back at a rate of, I believe, 232, and now recently they are coming with an IPO of around 500 rupees. Yeah, so there are some things which you need to just let the all the IPOs list, let it consolidate, and then understand how market is taking all these IPOs, and then take a bet on all these IPOs. So that is the another way of dealing with IPOs, I believe. And all this information which I have shared in, you need to verify your end. I am not a SEBI registered analyst or an advisor. Okay friends, hope you like this video. Thank you.